What's up, everyone? Soldier First Class here, and today's mission, we've got some Final Fantasy VII Remake news. Famitsu Magazine just published an article about an interview with Final Fantasy VII Remake director Tetsuya Nomura. In this interview, Nomura clarified some information involving the Honeybee Inn, the story behind Tifa's design, and a few things about the game's story. Some of the things he talked about left us more questions than answers, but hopefully we'll know more in the coming months. To begin, Nomura was asked about the story expansion that the game is receiving and what that includes. He stated, "There are quite a few additions to the scenario. While the main story itself hasn't changed, there are a countless number of new events. Otherwise, we wouldn't have two Blu-rays." I love the part where he said the main story itself hasn't changed. We no longer have to worry if the game will take us on some crazy made-up twists and turns, but that doesn't mean we won't be surprised by what the game presents either. Nomura also went on to talk about dialogue options and how they would affect how scenes played out. "There are quite a bit of dialogue options. We are making it so the dialogue changes depending on your response, so the sheer volume of dialogue has increased. This means that the popular relationship mechanic could be making a return in some form, or party members and the people of Midgar could form opinions about you based on your actions. This is something deeper than we saw in the original game, and a mechanic that has been included in some other major RPGs." He also mentioned some things about the ghost-like figures we saw surrounding Aerith and Cloud. Nomura stated, "The black mist creatures shown in the trailer are known as the Watchmen of Fate, which, by the way, sounds like something pulled directly from Kingdom Hearts or a comic book." He went on to say, "They are mysterious beings that will appear before the party wherever they go. I hope fans who have played the original Final Fantasy VII will enjoy these new creatures. Still no word on how they're connected to Sephiroth or Genova, but it will definitely be interesting to see what role these new creatures will play." He also talked about Aerith and Tifa and their new redesigns. He stated, "Aerith and Tifa are double heroines. One has a Western style, which is Aerith, and one has an Eastern style, which is Tifa." Nomura also talked about Tifa's design and the reason for the change. He stated, "We wanted Tifa to have abs, so she has an athletic body type. The ethics department at Square Enix also told us we had to tighten her chest as not to get unnatural during all the intense action. From there, we got the black underwear and the fitted tank top. I already know how the comments section is going to be after this one, so let me give a little perspective first, and then you can form your own opinions. In a previous video, I talked about Tifa's previously unrevealed remake design and how censorship would not come into play. Having said that, it would appear that there's a middle road to this hot-button issue. Square Enix does have a point when it talks about unnatural movement. In real life, we see it with athletes and female martial artists. Turn on a female UFC fight, and every fighter is wearing tightened clothing so that their range of motion isn't restricted by their anatomy. It also keeps a body part from being used as a weak point by an opponent. To clarify, I'm not okay with censorship, however I do believe that a character's design should fit with the engine and the characters themselves. Tifa's design fits her more athletic look, and the clothing change reflects that. We haven't seen Tifa in her Wall Market dress either, so don't worry too much. Nomura might still have some surprises in store for fans. To be fair, this is Final Fantasy and not the older games in the Dead or Alive franchise, where jiggle physics were a constant part of the art style. Square Enix would like these characters to continue their natural look and not be looked at for a gimmicky art direction that doesn't really fit the rest of the game. Besides, if Tifa constantly looked like this, it would definitely be off-putting during all of her scenes in the game. Nomura was also asked about the Honeybee Inn and if the cross-dressing Cloud scene would still be included in the remake. He had this to say, "The Honeybee Inn cross-dressing scene is still in. We've made it more modern. If we made the facility like we did in the original game, the physical unease would be staggering, so that was no good. It's still unclear what this means, but it's possible certain events will be altered slightly or the setup of them will be at least a little different." In all fairness, chibi models made that highly awkward situation more humor-based, and the correlating dialogue helped as well. That was okay in 1997 because you could chalk it up to comic mischief. However, fast forward to 2020 when the game releases, and showing that exact scene in today's graphics is gonna be, well, a little tough to explain to the ESRB. It makes sense that this scene would get redesigned as its original intent was that of a brothel. Things like this can give a game an M rating, and if Square Enix is truly trying to keep a T rating, then certain elements will get redesigned with this modern feel. I don't necessarily agree with this choice, but I understand why they're making it. Again, until we see how it plays out, we really don't know how much different it will be. Then we got a few pieces of mostly repeat information about the action combat, shortcuts, and tactical mode. It's already been heavily covered in my combat analysis video, so I'll link that if you're interested. However, he did add a few things that we didn't get at E3. Nomura stated, "An item is required for MP recovery. This will be different from recent title Final Fantasy XV, where MP was regenerated over time and will require the use of ethers." He also said that each playable character has different enemy affinities. If you recall from Final Fantasy X, each character had their own enemy type that they were strong against. Waka was really good against flying enemies, for example, and it would appear that this mechanic will be returning in the remake. Finally, his last words talked about new enemies and level design. Nomura said, "For the sake of level design, we're preparing a few new enemies where necessary." This definitely makes sense, because with Midgar being expanded to the size of two Blu-rays, that's going to be a lot more exploring. It would make sense for each sector or area to have some unique and new enemies we've never seen before, along with some of our old favorites. I'm excited to see what Nomura has in store for us in that aspect. Overall, we didn't get much from this interview, and a lot of questions are still left unanswered. However, Square Enix plans to have scheduled information reveals until the game releases. I can't wait to see what they have in store for us when the game launches worldwide on March 3rd, 2020. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to omni-slash that like button. Let me know in the comments section below if you're excited for the Final Fantasy VII Remake. Subscribe to the channel, and ring that notification bell to join the ranks of Soldier today. And for all the latest Final Fantasy VII Remake news, rumors, and trailers, I'm Soldier First Class, and I'm on to the next mission. Later, guys.